Good afternoon, and thanks for joining us on the web. I'm Jamie Staton. We are following breaking news coming out of Ukraine, where a Malaysian Airlines plane has crashed. Ukrainian leaders say it was shot down by a missile. Ukraine's president says the armed forces of Ukraine did not take any action against any airborne target. This happened on the border between Ukraine and Russia. 295 people reportedly on the plane. The airline has not confirmed that the aircraft was shot down. It does say that it lost contact with the plane over Ukrainian airspace. President Obama, who is on Air Force One as he travels to Delaware, has been briefed on the situation. Stay with News 9 on air and online as the story develops. We will have complete coverage this evening, starting with News 9 at 5 o'clock. In other news, several Laconia families have been told to leave their apartments because of what officials are calling deplorable conditions. 16 people, including 11 children, have been removed from the building. Officials say the conditions were unsafe. They cited obstructed doorways and garbage and debris in several units. We will have more on this story coming up on News 9 at 5 as well. Just into our newsroom, we know the name of the woman who died in a crash with a dump truck in Merrimack yesterday morning. 60-year-old Elizabeth McQuinn was pronounced dead at the scene. The investigation shows that McQuinn was making a left turn onto 101A when she crossed the path of the truck. The accident remains under investigation. Keene police have made an arrest following a confrontation over a controversial chalking movement. The Free Keene group says they have been writing peaceful messages around town, but others say the messages aren't always clean and they're defacing different areas around the city. 24-year-old James Phillips turned himself in after police say he assaulted a man during an argument about the chalking. City leaders are looking into an ordinance to stop the chalking, which doesn't qualify under the law as graffiti. And the Plainfield home of a tax-evading couple, Ed and Elaine Brown, it's about to go up for auction. Back in 2007, the Browns held police at bay for 9 months in a standoff, largely over taxes. Their fortress-like home, which sits on 100 acres, will be auctioned off on August 15th. The minimum required bid is $250,000. No tours are being given ahead of time. Authorities say there is a possibility that landmines and other explosives may be buried on the property. That's a look at the news. Have a great afternoon.